And we welcome you here to a beautiful day at the University of Pittsburgh and the NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championships. Jeff Hathorn and Christina Chauvinet here inside the Peterson Event Center in what should be a fun first round between the Towson Tigers and Penn State Nittany Lions.
Oh, absolutely. This is the closest matchup statistically of all the round one meets. The margin is razor thin. It could be anybody's meet today.
And this is part of the Pittsburgh region of the NCAA Championship, Maryland, Arizona State, and number two overall, the Florida Gators are part of that. Christina, who are some of the gymnasts to watch today?
Well, we have an exciting mix of veterans and newcomers that are contributing big things to these teams. Ava Piedrahita competed all around every single meet for Penn State, absolute rock star in her freshman season. Cassie Rushlow, season high, 9.975 on bars. Speaking of bars, Grace Valancourt, incredible bar worker there. She's also coming off a career high at Eagles of a 9.95. Isabella Minervini, one of their freshman phenom, all Eagle selection on floor and bars. Really exciting gymnastics this afternoon.
And the teams come in for Towson, and Jay Ramirez comes in off and first ever Eagle championship, and Jay has done an amazing job with the Towson program.
Absolutely. Jay Ramirez, they came in second Eagles last year, so close to winning that Eagle championship, first Eagle championship in Towson history. The athletes and the coaching staff were so thrilled with that, and it really was a very complete performance from Towson. So if they could sign on the dotted line for that performance here this afternoon, I think they'd take it.
Jay has really reinvigorated the program and facing the Penn State Nittany Lions. Towson will start. It is in Olympic order with the Tigers getting underway right now with Jenna Wheats.
And this full twisting Yurchenko. Nice landing there to start them off. You can see she's stoked about that. Towson is going to compete a lineup of almost all of these Yurchenko fulls, that 9.95 start value. So really important to hone in on that landing like she did there. Really solid start.
Both of these programs excel in the first two rotations. Helena Varova up for Penn State on bars. Jesse Johansson up on bars. The first error is made by me.
A nice Tkachev there to Pac Salto. Little over on that half pirouette. We are going to be looking for those handstands to land right in vertical. See if she can get the landing on this dismount here. Hones in on that landing, little leg separation in the air. The judges are sitting off to the side, so sometimes they don't catch that, although a reminder that we are at four judges in the postseason, so more likelihood that they will catch that. Let's take another look at this dismount. Does this E-rated double layout? Yeah, legs come apart. Nice chest position on landing, though. That's something else that's going to differentiate the good from the great this afternoon.
Felicia Poblete up for Towson. A sophomore from New Jersey. What an opportunity for her here at the NCAA Championships. The first round here in Pittsburgh, as we are one competitor in on each side.
And she's one of those athletes that's really stepped into the lineup. Mia Davis, who has competed for Towson pretty consistently this season, had a minor injury, and she's one of a very powerful vulture for them. So, you know, Jay Ramirez has a lot of depth, has talked a lot about the depth that Towson has, asking some of those athletes to step into spots. So this is going to be a critical place for them.
We are awaiting scores, which has delayed us here off the beginning, and it's always that tough time. You see some laughter, maybe nervous laughter, but everybody's geared up to go, and you want to go, and you're just kind of waiting for a judge's decision.
Exactly. They try and keep it light. You know, also in the postseason, you have the corrals, the areas where the gymnasts are required to stay inside. So just trying to, you know, give that verbal affirmation to their teammate here. And a cool vault. She does that full-on tuck off. A fun deep cut for gymnastics fans, though it's known as a full-on. You only have to get three-quarters of the way around in order to not incur deductions. So really difficult to get that full twist around, and that's how it's written in the code of points, I think, just acknowledging that it's difficult to get that twist around. That vault does start from a 9.9, so just a little bit more difficult to get up to that. 9.95, so difficult to get up to that 10.0.
Maddie Johnston next for Penn State on bars.
Oh, missed that handstand there. Nice connection in that Maloney to Bale there.
That is a qualifier in the all-around in the NCAAs, even if Penn State does not advance.
And great job honing in on that full pirouette to double back. Unfortunately, she did have that short handstand at the beginning of the routine, but that's that full pirouette into the double back. Has leg separation on that second salto, but great job of nailing that landing.
Johansson with a 9.825 is the first score for Penn State on bars. Wheats with a 9.75, as up next for Towson is Adriana Hoffman.
And Hoffman, one of those newcomers for the Towson Tigers. And as we mentioned, a mix of some of those, the seniors and juniors that have been contributing so much, as well as some of that newer talent. So she's gonna be competing a Yurchenko full. As I mentioned, Towson does not have those 10.0 start values. So we're gonna take a look and see if she can hone this landing in. Didn't quite get the block, and by that I mean the rise off the table that we wanna see to get that those bigger dynamics. Let's take a look on replay here. Yeah, had some elbow bend on the table, but I will say she did a really nice job of controlling that landing. That's something I'm liking from the Towson lineup so far in this rotation.
Lena Virova now up on bars for Penn State.
And she is such a pretty gymnast to watch. I really love her toe point. You can see the toe point I'm talking about. Look how she maintains that during the Jaeger. So pretty. Nice handstand on that low bar. Borderline last handstand there. Good job working into that full pirouette, double back. Just the hop backwards, but nice routine overall.
So Johansson with a 9.825 and a 9.675 for Johnston.
And now that I see it in replay, just a little crooked on that Jaeger, but such pretty toe point. And just that baby hop back, that'll be a half a tenth deduction.
So Wheats with a 9.75, a 9.7 for Poblate. And up next is Lauren Bolin for Towson.
And you know, one of the interesting things when we look at Penn State versus Towson, the lineups are very different in how they are composed. A lot of athletes for Towson competing one or two events. These Towson athletes are on with their landings. I really love the air awareness that they're having, getting those stuck landings. Let's take a look here. Again, not the height that we want to see off the table. Could have risen a little bit more, but you can't ask for anything else in terms of no movement with the feet on landing.
And she likes vault in Pittsburgh. Last year, having won the event here at Pittsburgh, different venue,
right,
but same city, and a good performance by her on vault. Gabby Galantine is up next, North Carolina native for Penn State.
And she's only competed bars so far for Penn State this season. Such a pretty bar worker. NCAA gym fans may remember her from her time at Florida, a transfer from Florida, and she's just made such an impact on the Penn State lineup. We won't be seeing the full twisting double layout, I believe, unless they're going to surprise me, but you know, talked to Coach Sarah Shire Brown and said they, you know, had made that shift to doing, quote, just the double layout because it is very special. But look at this toe point she's showing off as well. Some leg separation in that Maloney. And just a little bit in the pack, but nice rhythm that she's keeping throughout this routine. And here's that double layout again, capable of doing full twisting double layout. Nice body position in the air, does have that hop back on landing.
Twice she won bars this year. Gabby Galantine for the Nittany Lions.
And let's take a look here. really pretty body position in the air, was just not quite ready for that landing.
Cammy Vidoff next for Towson.
And again, I mean, these athletes are really honing the landing. I've definitely seen her take that Yurchenko full higher. She is an athlete capable of doing the 1.5. Though when I talked to the coaching staff about it, they said, you know, playing it safe for this meet because they don't have the depth on vault, losing Mia Davis and some other athletes that have contributed there, so keeping her to the full. But she really has wonderful air awareness.
And Towson was coming off a 9.825 from Lauren Bolin. Eva Piedrahita will be up next for Penn State on bars. Nittany Lions 9.825, 9.8, 9.775, and a 9.625 through their first four, with Johansson leading the way.
And Piedrahita, so pretty to watch on this event. She's been so solid for them, really one of those athletes that just came into college and made that seamless transition. Five-star recruit as rated by College Gym News, and she has lived up to that. A little shy on that first handstand. Nice job on Pretty. Better job of keeping her legs together than we saw from some of her teammates earlier in the lineup. Nice last handstand there, gearing up for her dismount. Full twisting, double back, little step, but that was a really nice routine. And here we're getting a look at that Maloney. Little leg separation at the beginning, now that I see it in replay. But this full twisting double back, nice technique there. Just that little step back, that's going to be in the, that will probably be a half a tenth deduction. Half a tenth, the smallest magnitude of deduction that you can take in NCAA gymnastics.
Belanovsky up, the final competitor on vaults, and what an option to have as your six.
Wow, and she has gone big on vault this season. She really has maintains nice form throughout that vault. Let's take a look at her block and how high she gets off the table. Yeah, probably the highest that we saw from her teammates. Maybe just the teeniest of pike down, but gets great distance as well.
Second in all the Eagle in vault this year. As we turn to Cassidy Rushlow for Penn State, the final competitor of the first rotation here. It's the first round of the NCAA championships, the Pittsburgh region between Penn State and Towson. And I always enjoy these conversations. You see the different reactions.
Absolutely. And Rushlow, you know, bars NQS 9.925. I mean, she is just has such stunning qualities on this event. Career high 9.975. So she's one of my favorites to watch on this event. And we are going to see, the bar work from both teams is really lovely. But the extension she shows off is just, look at that handstand, gorgeous. I'd like to see a little bit more amplitude on that Jaeger, but she connects it nicely to the overshoot. Again, the toe point on top of the handstand, it's just exceptional work.
A four-time champion this year on uneven bars and a really solid performance.
Absolutely, and right here we're looking, it was just a little crooked on that Jaeger, but keeps the connection nicely and keeps her legs together on that transition to low bar. Getting a look here at her dismount, full twisting double back, and that's just one of those areas, you know, that is not quite a stick, unfortunately. So that's going to be a half a tenth. You know, overall, I think very solid performance for Penn State, though I've seen them be a little bit crisper on some of those landings with their dismounts.
And also a solid performance for Towson on vault. We will switch events. As coming up, Penn State will go to vault and Towson moves over to bars. We are through one rotation here, the first round of the NCAA Gymnastics Championships in Pittsburgh.
welcome you back to the Peterson Event Center at the University of Pittsburgh campus. We knew it would be tight, and no shocker that not only were they good scores, but it is a tight battle between Penn State and Towson here in the first round of the NCAA Gymnastics Championship. A tenth of a point really separates the two, and when we look at the highlights, you could see why. There were some really solid performances.
Yeah, I think both teams are going to be happy with how they did moving out of this first event.
And we start on bars. Jessica Johansson got it started right away.
Yeah.
Her and Cassidy Rushlow were impressive.
Yeah, really nice double layout there. You know, Cassie Rushlow, such pretty toe point throughout this routine that she shows off and does, just had the teeniest of baby hops there, but still absolutely gorgeous routine.
Johansson at 9.825, and 9.9 for Rushlow. For Towson, they start on the top two. Lauren Bolin, the senior with a big number.
And this is Polina Belanovsky, huge Yurchenko full there. You know, some of the athletes in the Towson lineup did not quite get the dynamics to push into that higher range, but they really did a great job of honing into those landings. So interesting, because for both teams, it wasn't their absolute best that they've done this season, but a solid start.
Yeah, and Towson dropping a 9.7 for Penn State, and head coach Sarah Brown, they dropped a 9.675. So no major mistakes through the first rotation in the NCAA tournament. Sixth year for Sarah Brown. Named the head coach in May of 2017, and has really feels good about the squad she has in the NCAAs.
Absolutely. You know, this is a program that is building. Interesting, because both of these programs are really on the rise. And when I talked to Sarah Brown about this, you know, narrowly missing a regionals berth last year, said they were just really excited to make postseason and to show everyone what they've been working so hard for this season. They've really been on a run in the past month. So, you know, just was one of those teams that was on the cusp, needed a couple of big meets to close it out, and boy, did they do it.
Yeah, of course, Sarah is no stranger to high quality gymnastics herself, a two-time Big 12 Gymnast of the Year. And, you know, for this Penn State program, you know, they have three regional qualifiers. They feel like they're pointing in that right direction. And, you know, when you have a 10-win season, you might think, oh, that may not. But in the Big Ten, with the quality of competition night in and night out, it really prepares you for opportunities like this.
Absolutely. And one of the things I talked to Sarah Brown about before the meet was how the Big Ten prepares them for postseason competition. You see assistant coach Rachel Innes there, speaking of college gymnastics greats,
yeah,
a gymnast at Auburn. And, you know, really, and when I talked to Sarah Brown, really talked about how the coaching staff as a whole really contributed. Same thing with Jay Ramirez, Ashley Sauer there, and him really work as a team.
Yeah, Rachel, anyone competing at Auburn obviously has some high quality in their career. And you could see how she's kind of that go-between. You can notice that already, you know, not that far removed from
Absolutely.
Competing herself.
Absolutely. And getting a look at the coaching staffs there. And you know, as I mentioned, for both of these teams, just, you know, they are making it to this round one meet. Of course, they want to carry on forward, but both teams have qualified individuals into that semifinal round. As a reminder, the second round is where athletes can qualify to nationals as individuals. So that's going to be something to keep an eye on, because one of these teams is going to move forward. The other team will have a couple of those individuals in rotation tomorrow.
Alina Varova will start off vault for Penn State. For Towson, Lauren Keener will begin on bars.
Well,
Penn State has a high of 49.375 this year on vault.
Yeah, this is both of these teams' best ranked event. So this is an exciting rotation. Towson is ranked 16th in the country on bars. Absolutely lights out rotation from them from top to bottom, and a lot of variety we're going to see in this Penn State lineup on vault, which I really enjoy. And that front pike from Varova, that vault starts out of a 9.9. She does have really nice form in the air. We'll get another look at this on replay. Nice job keeping her legs together. That hop forward, though, tricky because it is starting from a 9-9.
Sophomore Lauren Keener already on bars for Towson.
And what I want our viewers to pay attention to with Towson on bars is how their attention to detail, their between bar, their transitions, these dismounts, their air awareness is exceptional. And you're going to see that throughout the lineup. It's something that really sets them apart. When you're doing something like a ginger to overshoot, a lot of times you see athletes have a little leg separation in that transition. It's these things are what gives Towson the advantage in this rotation. They are so exceptional.
A season high of 49-4 for Towson on bars. Maddie Johnston up next for Penn State on vault. Penn State is blessed with so many all-around competitors.
Yeah, as we mentioned, a very different setup to Towson, who is competing a lot of athletes, one or two events. They compete a lot of all-arounders, a lot of folks contributing on three events. Maddie Johnston, we're going to see a full twist in Yurchenko from her. Same vault that we saw from the majority of the Towson lineup.
A 9.75 for Virova.
And does a nice job of coming up for that landing. I think her chest was a bit down on landing, so we'll see if we can get a look at that on replay.
You mentioned the corrals that the athletes stay in. It is different from seeing the mobbing after the events that you typically see.
Absolutely. And yeah, her chest was a little bit down, but she did a good job of getting her chest up quickly, moving to salute to minimize that deduction.
Now the first opportunity for Lauren Green here in this NCAA championship.
Just a bit shy on that first handstand, but look at this stalter work. So pretty. Into that piked Jaeger. Really difficult.
Towson started with a 9.775 from Keener.
Little step forward. I've seen her be crisper on some of those on the dismount. And taking a look here. This is really exceptional here. That front stalter work, unusual to see in NCAA, does it right into that E-rated release with that piked Jaeger. Double back, as I mentioned, just not quite as crisp as I've seen her, but still really nice routine.
Now after a 9-9 on bars, Cassidy Rushlow takes her opportunity on the vault.
And she is one of the athletes that can really get those superior dynamics on the full twist in Yurchenko, which when you're seeing the full twist in Yurchenko so many times as these judges do, that's what sets it apart. And really nice job there of honing in on that landing. Take a look at this on replay. When I see this in replay, flatter on the table than what I've seen from her previously, but really nice job controlling that landing.
Clara Hong up next for Towson.
And she is one of my favorite bar workers, not just in this competition, but in NCAA. She has such lovely extension.
Bar winner in early February this year.
And had a couple meets out with a minor ankle injury, but was able to come back for the postseason. And she's going to show off here this double front dismount. Look at the technique, little step on landing, but the technique that she shows through that, keeping that toe point throughout. Taking a look here, that half turn into, look at how she keeps her legs together. That's how you do a double front, folks.
So Keener and Green with 9.775s over on vault for Penn State. Johnston with a 9.8, Virova with a 9.75, and a 9.775 for Rushlow. Now Isabella Salcedo.
And she's doing the Omelianchik Oh, came in, didn't get very far forward on the table and didn't quite, again, get that block off the table. I know I sound like a broken record here, folks, but yeah, didn't, was pretty back on the table. I'm kind of surprised that she was able to end in such a good landing position. That Omelianchik, rare to see in NCAA gymnastics, and Penn State's got another one coming. I think that's the stick, I don't know what those, the stick ears, that's a stick paraphernalia. You know, they are the Nittany Lions, so I suppose that's in keeping with the theme.
Four athletes down on vault for Penn State. And Cammie Vidoff now on bars 4,000.
Some leg separation on that dinger, but connects it nicely to the low bar. Shy on that handstand. She's had a couple shy handstands in this routine. Nice landing on that full twisting double back, though. Yeah, and was just shy on that final handstand and at a couple other points in this routine, but does that full twisting, that E-rated release, and just a little, E-rated dismount, just a little bit of a foot shuffle on that landing.
Jesse Johansson for Penn State.
And really nice full twisting Yurchenko there.
Salcedo with a 9.675.
And yeah, I think she got docked for some of that lack of amplitude that I was talking about.
Hong with a 9.85 on bars. Grace Valancourt, the junior from New Hampshire, is up next.
And this is an athlete who is capable of very comfortably getting into that 9.9 range. She has one of the best double layouts in NCAA gymnastics, really takes it up into the rafters.
A third in the Eagle on bars. You see that NQS.
Yeah, NQS 991 in Eagle. That's challenging, folks. Look at the toe point, the smooth release to low bar. Gearing up here for this. Oh, she, you know, goodness gracious, she's got some great air awareness because she let go a little bit early on that. You heard me kind of, because I didn't know if she was going to get that one around, but she's such a quick flipper. And this is that transition that I was talking about. And here's her double layout. Yeah, I thought she was going to have trouble getting her around, but she is so seasoned, no problem on that landing.
Ava Piedrahita, the final competitor on vault for Penn State.
And another one of those athletes doing the Omelianchiks. I mean, I don't know if any teams that are doing two Omelianchiks. Wow. That is what you're looking for that vault. So tricky to land in that blind landing. Let's get a look on replay. Nice legs together, just a little bend as she comes in for landing, but she knew exactly where she was in the air. I've been so impressed watching her this season. Just as I mentioned, one of those athletes that just transitioned so seamlessly into NCAA gymnastics.
See why she's a five-time champion in the rotation.
Absolutely.
A 9.85 for Valancourt. Now Isabella Minervini.
And that Takachev to Paxalto connection, nicely done. Borderline handstand on that half pirouette. Nice handstand, that final handstand, though. And whipped that double layout in a little close to the bar. But again, what I have seen from Towson time and time again this season is their ability to drill the landings, even if they're not in a perfect position in the air. And that's why they're ranked 16th in the country. Look at the chest position on that landing. Beautiful.
Minervini was impressive, and we have seen great performances on both sides halfway through this competition.
Yeah, you know, I think that this is, both teams are going to be happy with where they are. This next rotation that we're moving in is going to be critical, because for both teams, you know, Towson moving to beam, that is their lowest ranked event statistically. Same for Penn State on floor. So this is going to be a really critical rotation for both teams to get through with hits so they can move on to events that are potentially higher scoring for them in that last rotation.
Well, it's as tight as we thought it would be. We'll add up all the scores. We'll give you the winners for each side as Towson moves to beam and Penn State to floor. It's the first round of the NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championships. Plus. First round of the NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championships here. It is the Pittsburgh region, and we told you this would be tight, and another rotation, a different leader. After Penn State was out by a 10th in the first rotation, Towson with a strong performance on bars has taken the lead. 98-175 to Penn State's 98-050.
Yeah, and you know, for this is pacing on about 196. You know, I would say Towson would like to be a little further ahead at this point. I've seen them be a little bit cleaner, and I don't know, maybe I jinxed them by saying how exceptional they were on bars. Nice routines, hits, but just a couple of deductions here and there. And honestly, the same could be said for Penn State. Didn't quite get some of those landings on vault.
Well, let's look at the bars and a few of the routines from Towson and how they found themselves in the lead halfway through.
And Clara Hong, as I mentioned, just one of the most exceptional double fronts in NCAA gymnastics. Just that little step, but so pretty. And Isabella Minervini, there's a reason she's all eagle on bars. 9.925 for her there.
And for Penn State over on vault, probably no surprise, but Maddie Johnston with a solid performance.
And she was really, of all of the vaulters that we've seen today, the one that did the best job of getting that block off the table.
And here is where there is no surprise that Pedra Hita would end up winning.
And just, well, she just really rocked that dismount, got good distance from the table as well. And as I mentioned, love to see an O'Melian chick in NCAA.
So now we move with Penn State on the floor and Towson moving over to beam. Do you think there's an advantage for either team how these final two rotations play out?
Well, I think overall it's an advantage to be in Olympic order. It's fun to finish on floor. It feels like a home meet, particularly for Towson, because beam is the event that has, they have a good lineup. They have very solid beam workers, but they just haven't put it together like they have on the other events as cleanly. So for them, they want to just get those hits out of the way and then go to floor where they can be extremely dynamic. So at this point in the meet, I've got to give the edge to Towson because they're going to end on floor. Penn State's going to have to end on beam.
Okay, you won back Jay Ramirez.
I have a tremendous amount of respect for both of these coaches.
Jeff Hathorn and Christina Chauvenet here at the Peterson Event Center, University of Pittsburgh campus. It's part of the Pittsburgh region first round as we look at the Towson Tigers on beam, and you see that mix continue. A couple of sophomores, a couple of seniors, a couple of juniors, and an experienced group that's going to be taking the beam.
Absolutely. Clara Hong, she's going to show off those same lines that we saw on bars. You see her warming up there. So she's going to show off those same lines on beam. Jenna Wheats, another one to keep your eye on there. She's got some really difficult combinations. We're going to keep an eye to see if she can get all of her dance elements connected. That's really important for the start value. And Grace Valancourt coming off a career high 9.95 at the Eagle Championship. So absolutely stellar performance there.
For the Nittany Lions on the floor, Manny Johnston will lead off. And we're scheduled to see Amani Herring. We could see Cassidy Rushlow, and we will see Cassidy Rushlow in the sixth spot. Herring trying to come back from injury. And you know, she wanted to compete in this NCAA championship, just not able to go, at least in this round.
Yeah, she did warm up and probably just made that decision. It is challenging for athletes that have a, you know, I think she had an injury earlier in the season and was not a season-ending injury, but working athletes back when they haven't competed in a while, it can be challenging that first time out. So, you know, not sure exactly what happened, but I think the coaching staff probably just made the decision that probably safer for now just to stick with that lineup.
Lauren Bolin has started on beam for Towson.
And good sign there, I think, from the start, because she was a little bit off in that back handspring layout step out, but was patient with that correction. Oh, my goodness. Just off on that front toss. And so, needless to say, it is going to put pressure on the rest of that lineup.
Towson leading by just shy of 2/10 of a point here through two rotations.
And let's take a look. She does this cat leap into the front toss. Yeah, her hips were just too far off. Yeah, did a nice job of finishing this routine strong, though. This back handspring, gainerful, sticks the landing. Good for her.
Maddie Johnston now on the floor for the Nittany Lions. See her score for the year and NCAA qualifier already in the all-around.
Wow, drills that double pike. And pretty twisting form there. Nice control out of that 1.5 to front layout. I would have liked to see a bit more rise in the layout, but great control on landing.
Maddie Johnston, as we're underway in the third rotation.
And taking a look at her first pass, this is her second pass. The 1.5 there, that Rudy, nice job there. And here's that 1.5 to front layout. As you can see, you ideally want to see that second salto rise even higher than the first, and was just a little flat in that layout.
Cassidy Stewart up next on beam. And every performance for Towson important here.
Yeah, this is a challenging situation to be in. But she's been a staple of the Towson beam lineup all year. Nice job there on that required full turn.
Season high of 9.825.
Oh, a nice fight there. She was pretty far off in her hips, but held on to it. And that's a tricky area right there, because she was trying to connect that front toss to the beat jump. And I don't know if the judges are going to give that to her or not. If they do not give it to her, that will affect her start value. So we'll try and keep an eye on that for you folks and see if I can see what the start value they give the routine is. Some tentative work here. I think just, you know, going after a fall in that two spot, it's hard to, you know, you're thinking a lot about not falling, hangs on to that 1.5. And when you're thinking about not falling a lot, you tend to just be a little bit tentative. And I think that's what we saw there. But I have to commend her, because this is a difficult position to be in. Here's that front toss. Does she connect it to the beat jump? It's borderline. I think the judges will probably give it to her. But that could be a problem area if they don't.
Ava Pietrahita up next for Penn State. has won this competition. She's won pretty much everything this year.
Yeah. We'll run out of time talking about all the things she's won.
What a tremendous season.
And she's one of those athletes that really shows off the controlled lunge in on floor. If you're wondering what exactly does a controlled lunge look like, we're going to take a peek here. And even there, her front foot was a little bit unsturdy, but she just brought it down immediately. Perfectly controlled step out. Pretty split position there. Ending with a double back here. That's the controlled lunge.
Idrahita following up a 9.775 from Maddie Johnston.
She's so pretty to watch on this event. I love her toe point. I love her extension. Take a look at her second pass here. That 1.5 she takes so high. Nice body position in that front layout as well. And here's that double back. You can see how she anchors her front foot before she takes the lunge back. That's what you really want to see. The control lunge is really, it should look like you're taking the step because you want to, not because you have to.
Now Clara Hong.
And 9.65 for Stewart. And so I'm not, I failed you, Jim Turnett. I did not get an eye on the start value. But look at that aerial to aerial combination on Clara Hong's series there. So pretty.
Second team All-Eagle on beam. Freshman year was former Rookie of the Week. And solid performance when Towson really needed one.
Absolutely. And I think that, you know, she just has some of those qualities. This is the aerial to aerial connection. Look how this is so difficult to connect right on. Her torso is squared over the beam. I love that work. And again, right here, look at her chest position. Absolutely no doubt there.
And now for Penn State, Jesse Johansson. You see her season average.
Another one of those athletes opening with a double pike. Back there, not quite as controlled out of that double pike. Pretty in the air.
Rahita with a 9.85.
Such a cool combo pass there, the 1.5 to Perini. And just a little bit of low chest position on that double back, but does a nice job of controlling that landing. So another solid routine for Penn State.
Grace Valancourt ready to go.
And, you know, Clara Hong really set them back on a on the right foot there, 9.85 for her. And Grace Valancourt, check this out, folks, standing front tuck into the beat jump. Are you kidding me? That is so hard.
It always amazes me how easy they make it look.
Yeah.
Grace is one of those that makes whatever she does easy.
Oh, gosh. Too bad. Just really way too far off on that backhand spring layout step out. Challenging position for them now because they will be counting one of these falls. So you can see kind of Grace regrouping here. You saw her do that difficult switch leap combination. Sticks that landing. Tough break for Towson. And here's that the top that I was talking about. Look, standing punch front connects to the beat jump. Punch front alone on beam, much less from standing, so difficult. Here's where things went awry. That back handspring layout step out, you can see her back foot was really far off. And when your hips get that far off square, off center, it's hard to save it.
Alina Varova on floor for the Nittany Lions.
And she's so pretty to watch on this event.
Low score for Penn State so far is a 9.775.
And she's actually a member of the Latvian national team. And her dad, Igor, was the Olympic champion on floor in the 2000 Olympics. So some good genes there.
Absolutely.
And you can see that bang off there, that full twisting double back. Great job there.
Has a floor win this year. Last year had eight scores of 9.8 or higher. Rahita and Johansson, 9.85s. Maddie Johnston with a 9.775.
Full twisting double back was the highlight of the routine for me tumbling wise, but she also showed off some really lovely dance through this routine. Let's take a look here. Full twisting double back, and just she was really close to the line, but she had great awareness of where she was and just no movement there.
The senior Jenna Waits for Towson, a beam champion about a month ago.
And here's one of those difficult connections. Wow. Nails it, no problem. And you know, this is a difficult situation for Towson because they're having to count a fall, and to try and get back on track is really challenging. But Jenna Weitz is such a tough competitor, and you know, you never know what's going to happen later in the meet, so really important to get this perform at your best as you move through the rotation, but really fought on that series there. Sticks the landing, nice job. And you know, for me, the highlight of that routine is that difficult combination she does, the switch split into the layout step out into B jump, and had no problem connecting this. Look how hard this is, folks. Into the layout step out, beat jump. So challenging. You know, just, and then here's that dismount did a nice job there of honing that landing. Just the series, that backhand spring layout step out, had a pretty big break there.
Isabella Salcedo. And, you know, it's difficult enough considering the pressure that you need to get every single tenth out of the beam if you're Towson.
Absolutely. But now,
Valancourt, by the way, a 9.25.
But Penn State still has to go and finish on beam. So, you know, plenty of gymnastics left here.
You're saying there's still drama ahead.
You never know what can happen. But Salcedo, this is a highlight for me. Get ready for this, folks. Punch double front. Goodness gracious.
Qualified for the NCAA tournament last year on floor.
Does that layout step out to fulfill her back tumbling requirement?
I love as a freshman, she had 8 scores of 9.9 or higher.
And the height on that front pike is so great too. You know, I mentioned a couple of the other routines didn't quite have the dynamics in the connection, but this, look at this double front, so difficult, folks. That is not even a front handspring. She just does that from a punch.
And now Lauren Keener.
And Keener, one of the veterans for Towson, or sophomores rather, excuse me, not one of the newcomers, but somebody who contributed a lot during her her freshman campaign, and really a very fluid beam worker.
6 podium finishes as a freshman for Keener.
That connection, the front toss into the B jump.
Wheats with a 9.625.
A nice routine for Keener. That's going to be a solid number for them, and really important too to turn around their momentum as they move to floor. Here's that cat leap. Would have liked to see some more height on that cat leap, but does make that connection into the front toss. And there's that gainer full, just the scoop back. But again, I think that routine was really critical beyond the number to turn things around.
Well, toughness comes with the Herring family, and she's decided she is good enough to go.
And so we'll see what she does for her opening pass here, because she was warming up an Arabian double front and was having some problems with it. So we'll see if she goes for that or sticks with something else. Goodness gracious. Talk about rising to the occasion.
Twice won floor this year. This first since the injury.
And was just a little flat on that layout, but good for her for getting that around. And my hat's off to her, because as I mentioned, she was struggling with that Arabian double front. in warm-up. And look at this. The height opens up for it. She was a little, you know, just a little bit short coming in, but handles that landing. 1.5. You see what I'm talking about here? Just has to whip that around a bit. But I also want to commend her for her performance quality, which is something, by the way, that I don't think is rewarded enough in NCAA gymnastics. I enjoyed the artistry that she brought to that routine.
So the Nittany Lions go back into the lead as we head to the final rotation of the first round of the Women's NCAA Gymnastics Championship here in Pittsburgh. It's the Peterson Events Center here at the University of Pittsburgh campus, the first round of the NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championships. And we again have a different leader. Penn State led after the first rotation, Towson led after the second, and Penn State back in the lead after the third rotation. Some struggles, Christina, on beam for Towson, although they were able to fight back and at least get it a score where they were to have a huge floor and a mistake by Penn State that Towson still has an opportunity here.
Yeah, you know, obviously this is not where Towson wants to be at this point in the meet, but I think they have to go, you know, Penn State does have to finish on beam, and that is a challenging place to finish. So all Towson can do right now is go out and do what they've been doing all season on floor, which is showcasing dynamic tumbling and good control of their landings. And that's from where they are at this point, that's all they can do. There's no defense in gymnastics, right?
There are a couple of 9.8 plus for Towson on the beam, starting with Lauren Keener.
Yeah, and Lauren Keener in that anchor spot, so important, as I mentioned, to turn that momentum around. Solid back handspring layout step off for her, and Clara Hong, just so lovely. Look at this work, aerial. She really is an exceptional beam worker. Excited to see her in that postseason. Nails that landing.
Got a 9.9 from one of the judges. On floor, Penn State was exquisite.
And I think I jinxed Petra Haid on this one because she had a little bounce out of that double pike. Still so pretty, though, and nice connection work in that 1.5 to front layout.
Bella Salcedo, one of three gymnasts for a 9.85.
And so dynamic in that punch double front. And there's that, you can see her teammates getting hype about that finish. Yeah. Shout out to our camera crew and production team.
Do an outstanding job. So three finish tied for the lead as now Penn State will go to the beam for head coach Sarah Brown. Petra Hita will lead off, and then Johansson, who also had the 9.85 on the floor. Salcedo, Haley Gibble, Cassidy Rushlow, and Maddie Johnston.
Yeah, and you know, this has been an event that's been a little bit up and down for Penn State so far this season. NQS 49-105, their season high here, 49-425, though. So really capable of a big number here. Looking at Towson, their season high, you know, they're coming in with an NQS of a 49-375. They can be really strong on this event. So, but at this point, they're going to need some help from Penn State to win this meet.
And they're going to need three freshmen to step up in this first opportunity. But I don't think they're typical freshmen. I think it's three freshmen that have performed at such a high level that will make this final rotation interesting.
Oh, yeah, for sure. You know, finishing on beam is never an easy feat. And so that is, you know, the meet is really in Penn State's hands. If they hit five solid routines, they're moving on to the next round. But, you know, Towson, as I mentioned, they have the opportunity to end this meet on a high note and see what happens.
Nittany Lions coming off a seventh place finish in the Big Ten. But again, the Big Ten is so highly regarded. They did beat a Maryland team who they will see if they get to the next round. Maryland part of this.
And there's some Maryland folks there in the crowd.
Part of this Pittsburgh region.
Yeah, the Maryland team in the house, where I also commentate. So very familiar with that team. They did get a bye to the second round.
Oh, that's nice. They're saying hi to you.
Yeah, exactly. They might hear me from up here. But they, you know, as a reminder, there are nine teams qualified in each regional, bottom two in each regional in this round one meet. And the winner of this meet will go on to that semifinal tomorrow.
Florida and Arizona State, the other two teams. Towson looking for a big reversal here in the final rotation so the Eagle champions could continue here. And of course, they're familiar with the Maryland squad. Their campus is not far apart from each other.
Absolutely. You know, and should Penn State advance? I mean, this is a semifinal where the winner of this meet could move on to that round of 16 if, for example, Arizona State does not have one of a stellar performance from them. They do have, if Penn State has one of their best performances, remember they went 197 at Auburn. So, you know, they can push some of those higher ranked teams.
Ava Piedrahita. How about a pair of 9.85s and a 9.8 so far for Ava?
I mean, she's been so consistent for Penn State. Look at that, back handspring layout step out. When I talked to Coach Sarah Shire Brown about her, she said she's just a really calm and cool, collected athlete. And, you know, she said sometimes I don't even think she realizes how good she is. That's how chill and collected she is. That cat leap into the side aerial, really solid there. And handles that switch split into tuck three-quarter well. Just the dismount here. Hangs on to that stick in terms of no feed movement. Should incur a little deduction for lack of control, but that's a solid start for Penn State. And this back handspring layout step out was very solid. And then there's that 1.5 dismount. Again, just can't quite control it, but pretty in the air.
The freshman from Wisconsin, Paulina Belanovsky. Family, her brother, a gymnast at Michigan State.
Oh, just a little bit of a misstep on the landing of that front double full, but handles it. Stretch through those dance elements. The TU choreographed into all of the Towson floor routines, and Ashley Sauer, the assistant coach, works really closely with Jay Ramirez and does a lot of the choreography and dance work. Pretty routine to start them there.
Jessica Johansson.
Very clean on that back handspring layout step out. The landing was nice. Unusual beat jump step out to that aerial, which I enjoy seeing that variety. Nice control on that switch side.
Penn State in the lead. We're in the final rotation here, the first round of the NCAA Gymnastics Championships.
And again, another smooth routine for Penn State. Just, you know, a couple of minor form things throughout. Let's take a look at this back handspring layout step out. Good control of that landing there, though, that handspring layout step out. 1.5 off directionally a bit there, but controls the landing. Again, I mean, all Penn State has to do
is solid.
Yeah, hit 5 routines, you're moving on to the next round.
Jenna Wheats next for Towson. 9.825 for Belanovsky.
Yeah, solid start. And Jenna Wheats, a really powerful tumbler. Control of that double pike. And another really strong routine. She did have a ring leap in there, really difficult for that with that head release, that she might get a little deduction for not getting full positionality there. But this double back, just over-rotate it a tiny bit.
Bella Salcedo up on beam for Penn State. Salcedo coming off a 9.85 on the floor. Johansson now co-leader, 9.85 for the Nittany Lions.
And check this out, folks. Again, another standing front tuck. Wow, she was a little bit off on there on that, so props to her for saving it. But, you know, we've seen one from Towson, one from Penn State, and I don't know if anybody, Jim Turnett, let me know, is anybody else in the country doing a standing punch front on beam? I don't think so. Nice wolf jump there, really high jump position. It was maybe just a smidge short of split there. Hangs on to that landing. I mean, again, Penn State is doing what they need to do. And again, this is so difficult. It's amazing we're seeing two of these in one meet. Just to go from standing, and she was a little bit off, but she was patient with the correction, and that's what you need to do on beam.
Carmela Carafate. And Towson is doing what it needs to do. Another 9.85 on the floor.
Yeah, they are very solid on this event, but unfortunately for Towson, Penn State is also doing what they need to do. So not a lot of room for them there unless we see some mistakes in the Penn State lineup. Front double full, two punch front pike, so difficult. And, you know, Towson is showing off why they are so strong on this event. really great control of their tumbling passes. Check this out. Front handspring, front double full into the front pike. You don't see many athletes connecting a skill out of a front double full. And here's that 1.5 to back layout. Cool combination, nice control there.
The freshman from Pennsylvania, Haley Gibble, next for Penn State.
And, you know, we talked about those athletes that Penn State has doing all around. She is only doing beam today, but she's so pretty to watch on beam.
Bella Salcedo with a 9.8.
Goodness, I think I jinxed her.
Penn State still has room to play a little bit, if you will. This will eat into the Nittany Lions' lead a little bit as we're just past halfway through the final rotation.
Oh, and a challenge there because, again, she was doing the aerial to back tuck connection, and that was a slow connection, so I don't know if they're going to give it to her. Cat leap to switch side there. Just it looks ever since she had the falls, looking a little bit off. One and a half, lovely dismount. She has some really pretty qualities as a beam worker, but just not her day. And here's this combination. Here's the aerial. You see how she hesitates there into the back tuck. If I were a judge, I would not give that connection. Now this dismount was so pretty. So just kudos to her so hard at that point in time, but pressure on Penn State now.
Grace Valancourt, who has a 9.9 this year.
Things just got a little bit interesting here towards the end of this meet. Oh, and I don't think she went out of bounds. Just buckled a little bit in her ankles on that landing. Front layout, that is the rise out of that front layout that I was talking about. Pretty Rudy straddle jump there. You know, interesting because Penn State, again, there's pressure on Penn State here. Now, what happened in this double back? Let's take a look. Just, oh goodness, she kind of landed awkwardly on that front foot. Thought she might have even rolled it over, but she was fine the rest of the routine. This 1.5 front layout, she did get nice rise in that front layout. Now pressure's on here.
Able to keep those feet in bounds. Cassidy Rushlow, 9.775 on vault and a 9.9 on bars. And now a chance to get the momentum back for Penn State after a fall.
Absolutely. They have two more athletes left. If I were Sarah Shire Brown, this is who I would want in this position, such a seasoned athlete. I love her toe point. And here's that series. It's maybe just a hair off, but manages the correction with minimal correction movement. Oh my goodness. Well, folks, this just went from they've opened the door a little bit to now this is anything could happen at the end of this meet.
I saw the Towson area get all excited, not in a bad way, but in a, hey, we're back in this.
You know, they as much as you want to stay in your own corral and stay in your little bubble, these teams do, you notice what happens on the other event. And now they, this back handspring layout step out really nice, but this cat leap into the aerial just off on there. Still, I think, advantage Penn State, but these last routines count.
And here's how this has changed. Carafati now the leader with a 9.875 on the floor. And you go to Paige Casper, who is just a few weeks away from a 9.925 herself.
And she can put this double pike, just a little slide back, a big height there.
Christina, you had said it. It's so tough to finish on beam.
Yeah, it's, that is the hardest event to finish on. So, Penn State's had some great beam routines in the rotation and a couple falls. So, Paige Casper here getting set for her last. And maybe just a little short on that double back, but she is tough. She just jumped into that lunge, and overall nice routine from her.
And here we are, the final two competitors, Maddie Johnston for the Nittany Lions. Two times this year, Maddie Johnston has won beam.
Back handspring layout step out, very solid there.
Rushlow got a 9-1. And as you see the score right now, you can't be any closer without a tie.
That number for Penn State not reflecting the drop that they will likely have. Let me try not to jinx her here. Nice dismount there. A hit for Penn State just when they needed it. One and a half. Hangs on to that landing.
And now the freshman from Fleming Island, Florida, Isabella Minervini, will likely decide if her team moves on in the NCAA tournament.
Gorgeous front layout to one and a half there. Oh my gosh.
Paige Casper with a 9.8.
Wow, was not expecting that.
lowest score so far for Towson on the floor is a 9.75.
Well, and that routine will not count for Minervini. Very unusual mistake for her sitting down that double pike. And double pike here, just her shoulders were too far back when she landed. I think she might have just hung on to that a little bit too long.
The emotional swings of the last 15 minutes between these two teams. You see the Nittany Lions. The winner goes on to face Florida, Arizona State, Maryland.
And unofficial here, Penn State, 195-7. So they are going to edge out Towson to move on.
We're going to break and find out for sure who's advancing in the NCAA tournament. It's the Pittsburgh region. Welcome back to the Peterson Event Center in this tight competition between the Penn State Nittany Lions and the Towson Tigers, as these two teams battle and put on quite a show for us. Emotions going back and forth. I mean, you know what the pressure is. It's the NCAA tournament. You work all year to get to this point.
Yeah.
And these two teams went down to the last competitor.
Absolutely. You know, not either team's best performance. And coming into that fourth rotation, you know, you had said, Jeff, that Penn State, you know, in control, and noted that they had to finish on beam. They had some challenges, and Towson couldn't, you know, had some great performances in there, but couldn't quite get enough to get past them in the end. Congratulations to Towson, though, on an absolutely phenomenal season. Eagle champions, first time in program history. This is not the way they wanted to end their season, but they got a lot to be proud of.
So Penn State wins it 195-7 to a 195-4-5. As Towson will have three at least move on as individuals. Pelinovsky, Minervini, and Valancourt.
And as a reminder, when the team that does not advance, those individuals that advance to the next round, they will rotate with one of the qualifying teams. And how individual qualification works is, out of the teams that qualify to the national championship, the highest person that is not on a qualifying team on that event will qualify. So they made it a little bit easier. It used to be that you had to win the event outright. I'm glad that they changed those rules. Still an uphill battle, because there's some great gymnastics that's going to be happening here this weekend. But yeah, this is you know, still a lot of opportunity for those athletes to move on and compete in that next round.
Your podium finishers for today on vault, Ava Pedrajita and Paulina Belanovsky for Towson, shared at a 185, tied for first. And Lauren Bolin from Towson with a 9.825 was third on bars. Minervini a 9.925. Cassidy Rushlow with a 9.9. And Clara Hong and Grace Valancourt for Towson, each with a 9.85. On beam, Jessica Johansson, 9.85. Maddie Johnston, a 9.85, and Clara Hong with a 9.85. Of course, the top two from Penn State. And on floor here in Pittsburgh, Caramella Carafate with a 9.875. Pedrajita, Johansson, Bella Salcedo, Amana Herring, Jenna Wheats, all with a 9.85. Courageous from Herring, really good scores on the floor as it came right down to the end.
Absolutely. And you know, this is an exciting it was such an exciting meet, and you look, that is the feeling that the athletes are reaching for, physically putting their names into that next round.
And for Penn State, you think you have it,
right?
Then you think it went away, and then right at the end you got it again. And Penn State won the first rotation. Towson took the lead after the second. Penn State had the lead after the third. And now Penn State will advance to face Florida, Arizona State, and Maryland. You mentioned the individual participants moving on for the Tigers, and you said it, a great year. First ever Eagle Championship. Towson has nothing to be down about. They gave it their best shot. It just was that close at the end.
And that's why these first round meets are so, we said it was going to be exciting at the top. It came down to the wire. Congratulations to Penn State. Really rallied at the end of that beam lineup to save that advance to the next round. And look out for them in that next round. They're going to be coming back wanting to get a score in that mid-196 tomorrow.
Well, I want to thank everybody for watching us this afternoon from here in Pittsburgh. My name is Jeff Hathorn. For Christina Chauvanet and our outstanding crew, thanks for joining us. Penn State edges out Towson, the first round of the NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championships here at the University of Pittsburgh.